Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have studied about the what are alkynes and what are the general formula of alkynes, and in that we have considered a few examples also, and we have also mentioned the IUPAC name of that examples. But it is very necessary for us to understand that what are the rules of IUPAC nomenclature of alkyne, and on that basis we could name it. So this is the one that we have did in our previous chapters also, that is in alkanes and in alkenes, and now we are going to do a separate lecture for that is the IUPAC nomenclature of alkynes. So let us do for that. So the rules are as follows that we are going to study about for IUPAC nomenclature of alkynes, and that is we have to select the longest continuous chain of the carbon atoms that consist of carbon-carbon triple bond, and that has been considered to be the parent alkane. For example, this is the same that we have did earlier, but now it has been related to alkynes. So suppose if we have this structure, and in this structure I didn't mention about the hydrogen atoms, I am just only considering about the carbon atom, and for which we have to select the longest chain. And in terms of alkane, if we would had, then this one would be the longest chain that I am considering over here, that is the 5 carbon atoms that I am taking, that is the one that consists of carbon-carbon single bond. But we are talking about alkynes. Alkynes are the one which consists of carbon-carbon triple bond. Therefore, we have to select the longest chain in terms of the one which consists of a carbon-carbon triple bond. So this would not to be said to be as a longest chain because it consists of 4 carbon atoms, as we could see over here. But what if I have considered this to be the longest chain? Now this one would be said to be the longest chain because it consists of 5 carbon atoms along with that of carbon-carbon triple bond. So this is the first rule that we have to always keep in our mind, and should always consider that while selecting the longest chain of carbon-carbon bonds in alkynes, so we should also consider that it should consist of carbon-carbon triple bond. So this was the first one that we have did, and let's talk of the second rule that we are going to learn about, and that is we have to number the carbon atom of the chain from that end which is nearer to triple bond. So even this is very similar to that of the IUPAC nomenclature of alkyne, in which we have to give the less number to the carbon-carbon double bond from a particular end. That is, if a particular end has from where we give number, and if that end will get basically carbon-carbon double bond a very less number, then that is the sequence that we should follow. And similar to here also, we have to number from that end where we could get the carbon-carbon triple bond to be having a less number. So in this case, if you see that the numbering can start from anywhere, that is from both the end, but the priority is we should give the number from that end where we could receive the carbon-carbon triple bond to get a very less number. So if I started from here, that is if this carbon would have called to be carbon number 1, this is carbon number 2, 3, 4 and 5. So ultimately I am numbering it, but is that a right method according to the IUPAC? No. We have to number it from that end where we could get that is less number to the carbon-carbon triple bond. So therefore this one will be the first one, this one will be the second, this is third, fourth and fifth. Now this is the correct method to number the alkyne or the position of the carbon-carbon triple bond. So now the next is the name of the alkyne is basically derived from the alkane, so therefore it is done by replacing the suffix ane from the name of the parent alkane by yne. So suppose if I consider this to be the longest chain and it consists of basically 5 carbon atoms, making this to be called as pentane in terms of an alkane. But this is not pentane, this is basically pentyne. The reason behind that is I have replaced the ane of the pentane by yne. The reason behind that is I could see that there is carbon-carbon triple bond, and because of the carbon-carbon triple bond it is called to be alkyne, and hence the name is pentyne. So even this are the two rules that we have mentioned very clearly, and now let us follow the third rule. That is, the fourth one is, The position of carbon atom from which the triple bond starts is indicated by a lower number. So this is what we have did, that is in rule number 2, and we have to give a provide a less number. So this is what we have did over here. And the next is the locate number indicating the position or of the triple bond is placed immediately before the suffix Y and E, because as I have mentioned over here, that is, this is nothing but a pentine. That is true, but we could see that the carbon-carbon triple bond is being observed between the carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. So therefore, this is the number that we are going to express, that the carbon-carbon triple bond is between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. So therefore, the name is not pentine. Actually, the name of that would be pent-3-I. So this number plays a very vital role, and this gives us the information that where actually the carbon-carbon triple bond is in the whole parent chain. So this is what we have did over here. That one was the fifth one, and now let us move on with the next rule that we could always keep in our mind so as to express the rules of alkene. So now let us move on with the next rule that we have, that is this one. So the sixth one says that the position of the branches is indicated by the appropriate locate. Even we could find that in aliphatic alkyne, it is not necessary that or it would be a straight chain, it could consist of a branched also. So even we should mention the number or should mention the locate of the branch that we could observe in the whole parent chain, and that is what it has been expressed as. And talking about the next one, that is the seventh one, the compounds with more than one triple bond are basically known as dienes, trienes, etc. So this is what we have did in the topic where we have discussed about what are alkynes, and doing and talking about the next one, that is the compounds containing both double bonds and triple bonds are called enines. So this is the main thing that we are going to do, that is the alkynes are the one which consist of which can consist of basically double bond also, but mainly it is alkyne is the name because of the carbon-carbon triple bond. But yes, there are certain compounds where we could find carbon-carbon triple bond along with carbon-carbon double bond. So this kind of molecules which consist of carbon-carbon double bond as well as carbon-carbon triple bond are basically known as enines. This EN, that is EN, it stands for, that is the carbon-carbon double bond, while YNES, that is it stands for carbon-carbon triple bond, and together it is called to be enines. But if that is been present, so how to number that? Yes, then the numbering of enines chain starts from that end nearer to the first multiple bond. So what I am talking about, let me explain you. Suppose if the carbon-carbon double bond, if it starts from suppose this end, as you could see over here. So suppose if this is an enine, because it consists of carbon-carbon double bond as well as carbon-carbon triple bond. So the numbering will be done from which end? The numbering will be done from that end where we could find the first multiple bond. And talking about multiple bond is the one which is starting from carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon triple bond, and so on. So that is the reason the first multiple bond is nothing but carbon-carbon double bond. And hence, the numbering will start from that end where we could find the first multiple bond, that is the second bond. So in this case, suppose if I move from this end, so I could get the carbon number second as from where we could get the carbon-carbon triple bond, and at carbon number 4 we could get the carbon-carbon double bond. But according to IUPAC rule, as we have just now we have learned, that is we will start the numbering from that end where we could get the first multiple bond very near to that end. So therefore this one will be numbered in this manner, that is this one would be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So therefore this is the rule that we have to follow, and we are going to do the examples also in our next lecture. So let us have it. This is also a main thing that we have to keep in our mind. So the next is, suppose if both double bonds and triple bonds are equidistant from either ends, then the numbering should be done from that end which is nearer to the double bond. So that is what we have did over here to make us understand that suppose if at any cases, suppose if we have to nomenclate a particular hydrocarbon which is basically an alkyne, and in that alkyne suppose if we have found the carbon-carbon double bond, and suppose if while numbering we get a carbon-carbon double bond as well as carbon-carbon triple bond to be equidistant from the corners, from either from this corner or that corner, suppose in this example if I am explaining. So we'll number it from that end where we could find the carbon-carbon double bond nearer. So therefore the numbering will start from this sequence, as I have mentioned the example over here. So this is what the ninth rule was, and moving towards the last one, that is, which is very much important and that we have did in alkenes also, that is, if more than one triple bond is being present, then we make the prefix to be named as di, tri, etc., and which are been used before YNE. And the letter A is added after the prefix for the number of carbon atoms. Let me explain what I'm talking about. Suppose if in this carbon atom, or if in this hydrocarbon atom, I find a carbon-carbon triple bond over here. So according to the IUPAC rule, we have to number it from that end where we could receive first multiple bond very near to that end. So therefore again it would be the similar thing, that is, this is the first triple that is multiple bond, and again I am finding a multiple bond over here, as you could see. And the numbering will go on the sequence as I mentioned in the red ink, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But in this case, I could see that there are basically two carbon-carbon triple bonds, that is over here and here. So therefore, the name of this would be what? So according to the, in terms of, and I'm talking about just the parent chain. So in terms of the parent chain, I could say that it consists of five carbon atoms making this to be called as pentane. But this is not pentane because it is an alkyne. So therefore, the name is pentane. Again, we have to express the position of the carbon-carbon triple bond. So therefore, the carbon-carbon triple bond starts from carbon number 1 and it starts from carbon number 3, making this to be called as, in terms of, I'm just talking about the parent chain. So therefore, this would be called as penta. Yes, penta 1 comma 3 diene. So this A represents that there is a multiple carbon-carbon triple bond, and that is the reason we have expressed the letter A after the number of carbon atoms in terms of an hydrocarbon or in terms of an IUPAC name. This is called to be pent, and that's the reason the name has been changed to penta, and we have added A after the pent, and we have expressed the whole thing, that is how this is an alkyne and where is the position of alkyne. So these are the rules that we have to follow, and then only we could be able to name a particular structure's IUPAC nomenclature based on whether it is an alkyne. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and we are going to do a topic on the structural form of IUPAC as well as the IUPAC nomenclature of the structures. So stay tuned, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.